Hello everyone, in today's video we are going to discuss about one more problem that can be solved using dynamic programming by name Warshall algorithm. Note that this Warshall algorithm is basically used to find the transitive closureness in case of a directed graph. Hence I have made the first point as Warshall algorithm is used to find or used to compute the transitive closureness of a directed graph. Most of us know what do you mean by the transitive property. That means if A is a friend of B and B is a friend of C, then I can say that A is a friend of C. The same thing applies here also. Now, to understand better what exactly this Warshall algorithm does, let me take a sample input. Note that the input to a Warshall algorithm is a directed graph. Let me take a directed graph. Now this is a directed graph with 5 vertices and 5 edges. Now how to represent this particular graph? You know that anyway this is not a weighted graph. This is the edges are not having weight. So what I can do, I can represent this matrix or this particular graph in the form of a adjacency matrix, wherein it gives information about whether edge is there from a particular vertex to another vertex or not. So I'll write the adjacency matrix for this. So adjacency matrix order has to be n cross n, where n is, maybe in this case if n is 5, the matrix order should be 5 cross 5. A B C D E. A B C B and E. There is an edge from A to B, just only one edge. There is an edge from B to C, only one edge. From C there is an edge to E. There is an, from D there are no edges at all. Sorry, B there are two edges. One edge is to C and one more edge is to D. And from E there is an edge to A. I can say this is the input. This is the input for the Warshall algorithm. Now what should be the output? Output once again have to be an adjacency, have to be an adjacency matrix. So we, maybe here you can see the second point. In the first point I told the Warshall algorithm is basically used to compute the transitive closureness. Now what do you mean by transitive closureness? The transitive closureness of a directed graph with n vertices can be defined as a n cross n boolean matrix. This has to be an n cross n boolean matrix once again. N cross n boolean matrix denoted with T, and the value is nothing but is Tij. That means each of this value in this 5 cross 5 matrix can be denoted as a Tij, in which the element in the ith row and the jth column may either be 1 or it can be 0. When it can be 1? If there exists a non-trivial directed path from ith vertex to jth vertex. Anyway, from this input, I can know that if there is a direct edge from one node to another node, it can be represented with 1. On applying transitive closureness, if there is a path from one node to another node, not necessarily a direct path, if I can reach C with the help of B, then it implies from A, I can reach C also. Now, with respect to A, check whether A is reachable to A. If I take this path A to B, B to C, C to E, and from C to A, even A to A is also reachable. So this should be 1. A to B is all is from the direct input itself is reachable. A to C is reachable. A to D is also reachable. A to E is also reachable. Now similarly from B, check whether from B I can reach A. B to C, C to E, E to A. B to B, same path from A go to B. B to C is reachable. B to D is reachable. B to E reachable. From C, C to A is reachable. C to B reachable. C to
C is also reachable. C to D is also reachable. C to E reachable. Now from D, is there any outgoing edge? Problem is D does not have any outgoing edge at all. So under row D, all are zero. From E, A is reachable, B is reachable, C is reachable, D is reachable, and E is reachable. So this is the output of the Warshall algorithm. Note that the Warshall algorithm gives the transitive closureness of a directed graph. Now what we will do, we will take a small example to see how exactly the Warshall algorithm works, and then we will go for the algorithm and the efficiency of the Warshall algorithm. In order to trace Warshall algorithm, let us consider a small graph with 4 nodes, in the sense the value of n is 4. N is the number of vertices, and this graph is represented in the form of the adjacency matrix denoted with A, something like this. If you see, there are 4 edges. There is an edge from A to B, hence A to B is 1. And then there is an edge from B to D, hence under B to D it is 1. Next, there is an edge from D to A, D to A is 1, and D to C is 1. Now, depending upon the number of vertices, we will have those many iteration. Now, let me denote this R. Then let me denote this adjacency matrix with a variable R0. Let R0 be the initial adjacency matrix. Now, as there are 4 vertices, I will have 4 iterations. This is almost similar to that of the Floyd's algorithm. That means that we denote the first iteration as R1, second iteration as R2, third iteration as R3, and last iteration as R4. Now, in first iteration, I should take first row, first column as the reference, second iteration, second row, second column, third iteration, third row, third column, and fourth iteration, fourth row and fourth column. So what is first row? In case of first iteration, first row and first column of the previous one will remain as it is. First row is 0, 1, 0, 0, and first column is 0, 0, 0, 1. So this remains as it is. So this will be the reference. Hence I will take this first column on the left hand side, and even this first row on the top as the reference. Now what we are supposed to do here is, in order to calculate the other remaining values, we need to perform this operation. That is, old value or and operation of the reference value. This is reference 1 and this is reference 2. We know that this AND operation will be true only if I have both as 1s. 1 plus 1 and 1, 1 and 1. It will be 1. If any of these two are 0, any of these two will be 0, then it is 0. So, please note that if this reference are zeros, no need to consider it all. Reference, either the row reference is 0 or column reference is 0, you can directly take the old value. Only if the reference value is 1, then only we need to calculate. So, this is 0, hence directly take the previous row value. Here also, third row, reference is 0, so none of the value gets changed. Even you can come down to column wise also, even this third column will be as it is. Fourth column will be the previous value only. Only thing is this, because this is 1 and this is 1. 1 and 1 is 1, 1 or 0 is 1. Done. This is the first iteration. Now go for second iteration. What is second iteration? In second iteration, the reference will be second row. Second row is 0, 0, 0, 1. And second column. Second column is 1, 0, 0, 1. 1, 0, 0, 1. Now, only if it is 1, you need to consider. If it is 0, you can directly take the value of the previous iteration. Both these rows are zeros. Reference rows are zeros. So, directly take the value of the previous one. Anyway, here it is a second row and the reference is the second column. You can take this directly, then you can go for the calculation of the other part. Third row is 0, hence this. First row, first column here is reference is 0, hence there will be no change. Even this third row, third column, reference is 0, hence no change. Only this value. 1 and 1 is 1, 1 and 1 or 0 is 1. Now this value gets updated. Now go for Now go for the third iteration. Third iteration, the reference will be third row. Reference will be third row and third column. Third column is 0, 0, 0, 1. So I'll have here third row is 0, 0, 0, 1. If you see this, all columns are zeros. So directly you can take all these values as the value of the previous iteration. Previous iteration value is 0, 0, 0, 1. Same thing. Next is 1, 0, 0, 1. This is, I think I left this value here. Now 1 and 1 is 1. 1 and 1 is 1. And the previous iteration it was 0. This will be 1. So this is 1, 1, 1. Done. You are done with third iteration. Now go for fourth iteration. Fourth iteration. Let me write the fourth iteration. Fourth iteration reference is fourth row and fourth column. Fourth row is 1, 1, 1, 1. Fourth column is 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now calculate the value. Fourth row retain as it is, no change. Fourth column also retain. Now if you see this third row reference is 0, hence it will be the value of the previous one. It will be the value of the previous one. Now this is 1, 1 and 1, 1, 1 or 0, 1. 1 and here 1, no problem. Here 1 and 1, 1, 1. Next 1 and 1, 1 and 0, 1. 1 and 1, 1, 1 or 0, 1. 1 and 1, 1, 1 or 0, 1. So this is my final answer. Now I'll mark this as A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Implies that from A, you can go to all the vertices and even you can come back to A also. A to B is reachable, A to C is reachable, A to D is reachable. And even from A to A is also reachable. Now coming to B, it states that B to B is reachable, B to A is reachable, B to C is reachable, B to D is reachable. From C, as there are no outgoing edge, you can't go to any of the other vertices. Hence, you have 0 from C to all the other vertices. From D, you can go to A, you can go to B, you can go to C, as well as you can come back to D also. So, this is the final output matrix. Hope this was clear. We'll go on to the algorithm of Warshall. This is about the Warshall algorithm. The algorithm is being named as Warshall, and the input to this Warshall algorithm is the adjacency matrix A, which has n rows and n columns. The description says that this implements Warshall algorithm to compute the transitive closureness using dynamic programming. Now, what is the output? Output is the transitive closureness of the diagraph. You see that the output was referred as R4. So my R4 is the output. Now what is this 4? 4 is nothing but the number of nodes in the given directed graph. Now initially what we do, we initialize this adjacency matrix A to R0. That is my first step. A is being initialized to R0. Now this outer for loop is for the number of iteration. For I is equal to 1 to n. Now this for j is equal to 1 to n and for k is equal to 1 to n. You saw that what was the actual thing that we used to do? We used to do this operation. Old value R with the reference two values with the AND operation. R AND. So if you see RK of J is equal to RK minus 1 IJ. That is the previous, this is the old value. And these are the two, the referred value. That is in first iteration, it will be first row, first column. In second iteration, second row, second column. Third iteration, third row and third column, and so on. We used to calculate this. And finally, we used to return this R4, hence return Rn. I am returning Rn. Rn is nothing but the number of vertices. Now coming to the time complexity of this, if you see the time complexity of this particular algorithm is, the basic operation is this. Now how many times this particular step executes, this depends on how many times the outer for loop gets executed. There are three for loops running from 1 to n. Hence the time complexity of Warshall algorithm is theta of n cube. Hope this is clear. This was about Warshall algorithm. Thank you.